Blackstone Audio presents Frank Sinatra in a Blender by Matthew McBride. This book is read by Keith Szarabajka. To Charlie Sheen for winning. Introduction, Ken Brune. How important is a title? These days, vital. So many books vying for attention, and according to the experts, exclamation point, a book gets less than 5 seconds in a display to grab your interest. The cover, sure, plays a large part, but it's the name, especially for a new author. Take the ever-fascinating title, By Grand Central Station, I Sat Down and Wept. Then, and now, an arresting rivet. Matthew McBride was inspired when he wrote down his title. I have to fess up. Books sent to me to read as an attachment are not going to be a priority. More like duty, so they are already handicapped. I'm a Luddite. I like clocks, mobile phones, people to be simple, accessible, portable. And books, no ebook Kindle. What the hell ever is going to give the rush of a book in hand, the binding, the feel, the reassurance of an old friend? Rod Wythop, a cherished friend and connoisseur of music and mystery, asked if I would read a debut novel. For Rod, sure. But hey, don't hold your breath. It wasn't going to be anytime soon. Until I saw the title. Intrigued, I figured I'd sneak a peek and perhaps even subject it to the page 69 test. Wallop! I was hooked and got that frisson of being in the presence of something special. There is not a reader on the planet who doesn't relish, anticipate, hope to discover a new author, to be there for the very first book. It's rare to rarest found, twice in my experience. Only Jim Crumley and Daniel Woodrell fulfilled that criterion for me. And here was Matthew McBride. Best of all, I knew nothing, nada, about the author, so I read him, if not cold, at least without reservation. And oh, how sweet the growing joy of realizing this was indeed the real deal. Ticking all my personal data in your face. Hilarious, fresh, innovative, and a style so crafted, it seemed easy. To reveal the plot, the narrative, would be a true disservice. The magic of this book is to read it as I did, fresh and in the dark. Trust me, you will be fully rewarded. This is, to paraphrase a cliché, an offer you'll be delighted you accepted. Ken Brune, Morocco, April, 2011. Alcohol may be man's worst enemy, but the Bible says love your enemy. Frank Sinatra. I pulled into Norman Russo's driveway as the sun was seduced by gravity and evening set in. Orange and pink stripes blazed, then faded in the dead sky behind his neighbor's shed, in desperate need of paint. I let the Crown Victoria run while I finished the rest of my drink and set the styrofoam cup next to the short-barrel shotgun mounted on the floorboard. I dropped a 20-milligram OxyContin in the middle of a dollar bill, folded the bill up tightly, and smashed the pill to a fine powder with the rounded edge of a Bic. I rubbed the paper between my fingers to grind it up as best I could. The car shook as the wind slammed it from the side. I looked around. There were two empty police cruisers parked in front of me and an officer lighting up a smoke on the front porch. I dumped out the powder and rolled up a bill tight, then ducked down to snort a line half the length of the owner's manual for a 1997 Crown Victoria. When the oxy hit, my right eye began to water. I sniffed hard and took another drink of gin. I opened my door and the cold wind sawed deep into my bones. Chemical motivation cleansed my nerves as the world inside my head exploded and painted my mind with raw enthusiasm. Norman Russo picked a good day to kill himself. The weather was shit and there was nothing worthwhile on TV. Not that I watched much of that. I had better things to do, like drink. I nodded toward the rookie at the door like I was someone important. It worked. He gave a nod of his own. I should have brought my cup. The house was clean and had the look of a place with money. A nice home in an expensive neighborhood, meticulously maintained except for that peeling shed. An officer was taking pictures of the sliding door with a digital camera. I noticed there was no security system. Another officer asked who I was. I told him I'd been summoned by the chief, that they should have been expecting me. Valentine? I nodded. Right over there.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.